The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to our presentation today, MTV, the 80s and Women's History Month. My name is Sharon Ryan, and I'm the assistant director in the alumni office. I want to welcome you to this presentation and tell you how it works. You should be able to see the presentation on your computer screen, and you'll also be able to hear the presentation through your audio system. You can type in questions if you have any as the presentation is going on. We'll be monitoring them and we can ask them. And don't forget, in today's webinar, you're going to have the chance to win tickets to the show, I Want My 80s, the Best of MTV's Ladies, which is next Friday, April 6th, by answering the trivia questions that are part of today's presentation. So now I'd like to introduce today's speakers. Today's presenters are Professor Dave Philp, Assistant Professor of Music at the WP Music Department, student Sam Cruz, who is a junior public relations major with a music and entertainment industries minor, and Rachel Miller, who is a senior about to graduate and a music studies major. They will be talking about MTV, the history of the channel, and they will tell you about the performers from next week's show, including Taylor Dayne, Mark Goodman, one of MTV's original VJs, Chris Butler of The Waitresses, Darryl DMC McDaniels of Run DMC, Laura Majewski from Sirius XM, and WP's own alumnus, Rob Fusari, who worked with Lady Gaga, among others. And now presenting I Want My 80s, we have Dave, Sam, and Rachel.
Hello, everybody. How you doing out there today? Now, that was just one person, but imagine 500 to 800 of people making that exact same sound next Friday, April 6th. It'll be incredible. Won't it, Sammy and Rachel? Won't it, Sammy and Rachel?
For sure.
This is going to be the best webinar any of you have ever been a part of. We already know that this is the best webinar that we have ever been a part of. If we were with you right now, we'd be embracing you, but we can't. So why don't we just jump right in, huh, ladies?
Sounds good.
Sounds amazing. It does sound amazing. So here we are. We're talking about MTV the 80s and Women's History Month.
All right. So let's start out with just talking about the event next Friday, just to give you an overview of what's going on. So it is a fundraiser. It is to benefit William Patterson scholarships. So I don't know if any of you are music students or former music students, but it is a great cause. So definitely, you know, if you can come out, that ticket price is worth it and is going to make a difference for someone. It is an awesome show. We do have a student band, Sweet Dreams, also performing alongside our headliners, which as you see are Taylor Dayne, Darryl DMC McDaniels, Chris Butler, Rob Fusari as music director. And we do have two MCs, Mark Goodman and Laura Majewski, who we'll be speaking about more in a few minutes. So definitely check that out. We have School of Rock Wayne opening at 7 o'clock, show at 7:30. And tickets available now.
Okay, so our host of the show is Mark Goodman, and he was one of the first original VJs on MTV, and MTV first debuted in 1981. Here is a video about the first broadcast.
Yeah, this is actually the very first broadcast ever on MTV Music Television.
Music Television, the world's first 24-hour stereo video music channel. Just moments ago, all of the VJs and the crew here at MTV collectively hit our executive producer, Sue Steinberg, over the head with a bottle of champagne, and behold, a new concept is born. The best of TV combined with the best of radio. Now, starting right now, you'll never look at music the same way again. We'll be right back to introduce the other VJs and the other folks who are going to be with us on MTV.
So that person that you just saw was Mark Goodman. He was the first person seen in the first broadcast. That was him then in that black and white picture, and this is him now. He will be returning for his second year as an MC at one of our 80s events. We are really excited to have him, and he's really excited too. He has had a long career in the music industry, specifically in radio. He still hosts shows on the radio up to this day, particularly a show called Debatable on Sirius XM, which you can tune into. He's excited, as I said. Let's let him tell you himself what he thinks about this show.
Hey, I'm Mark Goodman. I've been checking over this list. I want you to come out and join me. It's the night of April the 6th, 7:30 p.m. I'm going to be co-hosting I Want My 80s, the best of MTV ladies. You got to be there. It's going to be happening at Shea Center for the Performing Arts on the campus of William Patterson University. It's a fundraiser for music department scholarships, a great cause, and it will feature the WP student tribute band, Sweet Dreams. They were awesome last year. They're back again. They're going to be playing with some pretty awesome performers as well. We've got Taylor Dayne. That's right, Taylor Dayne performing a selection of her hits with the band. Run DMC's Darryl McDaniels coming back once again. Going to be doing some Run DMC stuff, including Walk This Way. Plus, this year, we've got Chris Butler. Now, Chris was the mastermind behind the band The Waitresses. You remember the song I Know What Boys Like? Or even better, Christmas Rapping? Yeah, that was Chris Butler. He's going to be there. He'll be playing with the band as well. Rob Fusari, Grammy winner, back as our musical director. And I'm going to share my MC duties this year. We brought in my good friend, Lori Majewski. If you're a Duran Duran fan, so is she. You will bond heavily that night. So join us. Lori's going to be there as well. Buy lots of tickets right now. Call the Shea Center for the Performing Arts box office. The number is 973-720-2371. And you can go to the WBPresents.org website as well. Either way, buy tickets, lots of them. Now, do it. What are you waiting for? Go! Come on!
So there. Mark wouldn't have asked you to buy tickets if he didn't want you to. So why don't you just go ahead and do that? It'd be nice. Mark would appreciate it.
Very much. So as we had mentioned earlier, this is a women's tribute event, just as much as it's an 80s tribute event. All of the songs being performed, except for the Run DMC stuff, which is, you know, just an added bonus, which you shouldn't miss, by the way, buy those tickets, are by female artists in the 80s. While last year's tribute show was more of a general 80s thing, we're honing in on women. It is Women's Month right now. That was one of the inspiring things behind that theme choice. And we do have two really amazing, powerful women in the music industry joining us that night who we're going to tell you more about right now.
Me? I'm doing this one. Sorry. Note how I'm a male professor with two women who are talking about the women's thing. So Women's Month. So pretty cool. Good for me. So Lori Majewski, not a household name, but Lori wrote a really cool book called Mad World, The Oral History of New Wave Artists. That is actually, if you're into 80s music, it's really cool. She does interviews. She and her co-writer do interviews with people like Adam Ant and Chris Butler, who we talked about earlier and we'll talk about again in a bit, and a lot of other 80s artists. It's a lot of the sort of new wave stuff. It's the English music that was coming out in the early days of MTV, the early mid 80s. And you'll probably get a really big kick out of that book. So check out that book. If you're a listener or subscriber of SiriusXM, you can hear her on the Volume channel and also on the First Wave channel. And she's got a pretty cool background as well. But Lori would like to say something to you. I hope you don't mind.
Hey there, I'm Lori Majewski. Not only do I have shows about music on SiriusXM, I co-host some shows, but I wrote the book on the 80s, literally. I wrote a book about 80s music. I miss everything about the 80s, the hair, the music, the makeup. It was awesome. But for one night, we get to go back to the 80s. William Patterson is having this really cool event. It's called I Want My 80s, the Best of MTV's Ladies. It's on April 6th, Friday, April 6th, 7:30. Come join me and Mark Goodman, Taylor Dayne, Chris Butler from The Waitresses, Darryl McDaniels from Run DMC. How do you get these tickets? WP Presents, William Patterson, WPPresents.org. You got to join us.
So there it is. So Lori wants you to join us, and we want you to join us. And there's a great way that you can join us for free. We have a quiz right now, and we are going to give you a question. And I believe on your screen, there is a place for you to write in the answer to the question, I believe. Am I right about that, Sharon? Yeah.
Yes, you're right. Okay. Write it where it says question. Just write your answer.
Correct. And so I'm going to give you the question now. You guys type in your answer. First one to get it right wins the ticket. So if you have Google handy, you better type really fast. And don't just type with your thumbs. Use all 10 fingers. We are human beings now. All right. First question. Ready? What was the first music video ever aired on MTV? And who was the group? So you have to give us both parts, both answers to that two-part question. First music video, what was it? What was the name of the group? While you Google and while you do that, we are going to continue with, yes, Sharon.
We have one answer.
Really? What was the answer?
Video Killed the Radio. Didn't finish
Star.
It. Buggle. Yep. And the Buggles.
Yes, that is it. The Buggles. Video Killed the Radio. So the person who gave that, again, if we were with you, we'd give you just a nice warm hug. Everybody likes a hug, right, ladies?
We love hugs.
Yeah, hugs are nice. And I'll be with a back tap and all that. But so you're going to win a pair of tickets. And we will, after this, send you an email. We'll work that part out afterwards. So congratulations to you.
And it is Michael. And that is the person. Michael.
Michael? The big M. Miguel.
That's who Michael is.
Michael, you got Michael won.
Go, Michael.
Nobody thought Michael would do it, but it was Michael who won. So good for you, Michael. Happy Thursday. We can continue, Sharon?
Yes, you can continue. I hope you're going to do another trivia question.
Oh, we've got two more trivia questions.
Awesome.
We'll sprinkle them in as if this was ice cream and we had little dippity dots on top.
Okay.
So wait for your dippity dots. Moving on. Whoop, moving on. Here we go. What's happening with this?
Okay. So we have Taylor Dayne, as Mark Goodman brought up. She is a renowned freestyle and American pop singer from the 80s. She had her first hit single, Tell It to My Heart, in 1987, which reached number 7 on Hot 100. And she also had a string of other hits in the 80s and 90s, including Love Will Lead You Back, which made number 1. And here is Tell It to My Heart, the video itself.
But see this video by Sprint? Sprint is our biggest sponsor of the event.
That's true. So it's like the internet knows or something.
Exactly. They knew what we were doing.
They are contributing to our show. So let's give it applause.
That's
to
right.
Yes,
it's Sprint. Woo! But that is actually true. Sprint, actually, when you get your show program, open the inside front cover. That will be Sprint. They helped us out. And here's Taylor Dayne, Tell It to My Heart, on WPSC Brave New Radio 88.7 FM. Woo! So that's Taylor's biggest hit, and actually last year was the 30th anniversary of that song being a top hit, and Rob Fusari, who is doing the event with us, Rob Fusari, who's doing the event with us, and we're talking about Rob right now. The reason we have Taylor, the reason why we have Taylor Dayne with us, Rob is actually doing a couple remixes of some of her early hits as we speak. So that connection helped us get Taylor Dayne to come on out next Friday, April 6th, for I Want My 80s, the Best of MTV Ladies. Rob Fusari, if you're like, well, who's that guy, besides being a WPU alum, good friend of mine. He graduated with me at the same time. He also won a Grammy with Lady Gaga. The song you are about to hear was this, from the album The Fame. And this was a nice big piece of hit for both of them. Here we go.
Leather and jeans, don't fight glamorous. Not sure what it means, but this photo of us, it don't have a price. Ready for those flashing lights, cause you know that baby I'm your biggest fan. I'll follow you until you love me. Paparazzi, baby, there's no other superstar. You know that I'll be paparazzi. Come and so be kind, but I won't stop until that boy is mine. Baby, you'll be famous, chase you down until you love me. Paparazzi.
Yes, Rob Fusari's music can make the lame walk again.
Really, Lady Gaga, yes. Right? You know what's crazy? Sorry to just barge in there. But before MTV, there really were not a lot of music videos that happened. It was just kind of a big expense for record labels, and they didn't really see a point in it because it was such a new wave of culture. Can you imagine all the music videos we've shown so far on this webinar not existing because that gigantic cultural shift never happened? You have MTV to thank for that, and you should probably come out and thank it in person next Friday.
That was tremendous. Can we give Rachel a hand? What she just said?
Thank you so much.
That was not scripted.
Here all week.
That was a nice end.
Hey, you guys want to do another trivia question?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Let's do another trivia question. Are you ready, Sharon, to yell out the...
Everybody out there ready?
All right. All 15,000 of you. Here we go. And this is a five-part question. Name all five of the original MTV VJs. First names are good enough, but you need to name all five of the full-time original MTV VJs. If you were with me in the 80s, you'd be able to do it without Googling. Michael, we're looking at you.
Oh, Michael. He's in a lump. He's in a lump.
Come on.
Uh-oh.
What's happening?
We have an answer. Oh, five. There's four in this answer.
Well, let's see what they come up with.
Nina Blackwood, Mark Goodman, Alan Hunter, and Martha Quinn.
There's one more who passed away.
Oh, and J.J. Jackson.
Yes, Triple J. J.J. Jackson,
wow,
that's right.
Wow.
Who won?
That is Lazara. Lazara.
Lazara. All right, Lazara.
Yeah,
that is so, you are so much better than Michael at trivia. Everybody knows that. I'm sorry, Michael. I feel bad for you now. Give Michael 50 tickets.
Okay.
Lazar, you get a pair of tickets. Good for you. And we appreciate your participation with that. We're going to have one more question coming up, but not right now. So Rob Fusari, music director of the entire show, you're going to dig what he's done with, like we said, brought in Taylor Dayne, and he leads the student band, which is called Sweet Dreams. Who's going to talk about Darryl DMC McDaniels?
I will do that. So Darryl McDaniels, he is the, you know, the second part of Run DMC. He has performed previously at our last year's 80s show. He has a love of rock music more than hip hop, really. And as you can tell in this Walk This Way video, that there is a lot of rock influence, thanks to Steve Tyler.
That's right. We'll play this. By the way, just in case you're an 80s crazy person like myself, there were three in Run DMC.
Oh, yeah,
and
that's right.
Jam Master Jay, who was murdered about maybe a decade ago.
Yeah, in the studio.
And we had an interesting discussion. I co-host a radio show on WPSC, Brave New Radio, called Music Business 101 and More. And we had Darryl on last year, and he was talking a little bit. They've never found the person who killed Jam Master Jay.
He was very young, too. So.
Yeah. Hey, Sprint! Sprint is back!
Friends.
So let's thank Sprint. We should also, I'll mention the other sponsors we have. We have Columbia Bank as a sponsor. We have Oakland Spine, which is based in Wayne, New Jersey, and Oakland. They're your, I was going to say choreographer. They're your chiropractor. And there are more, Ruby's Travel. You're going to dig it. But listen to this.
Thank you.
All right. So let's walk this way. You probably know that. That was their biggest hit. And because of Run DMC, Aerosmith had a second coming of their career. They were kind of a B-C level artist at that point. And then this brought them way back.
And now they have a ride at Disney World. So thanks, Run DMC.
Yeah, thank you, Run. Exactly. So we mentioned Sprint. Ruby's Travel is a travel agency also based in Wayne, New Jersey. Because of Ruby, we were able to get Taylor Dayne to fly out here. And she also worked out hotel arrangements for us. We mentioned Columbia Bank. School of Rock in Wayne is also one of our sponsors. And yeah, Rachel is the manager of School of Rock. Who's the opening act for the Sadie Show, Rachel?
Our house band actually consists of students as young as 11 and as old as 16. They are absolutely amazing. Come see them yourself. Come a little early for the show.
That's right. Come about 7:05. They're going to do about a 15-minute set. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Very fun.
If you want to paint your house or put some wallpaper, Seal is painted wallpaper. We have Whitman Industries, which is waste collection. There's a deli in West Patterson. It's not called West Patterson anymore. What's the town?
Woodland Park.
My sister's deli. They're providing food for us in the early side. And then Blue Raven Entertainment is a promotions agency, and they're providing our merch for us. We're going to be selling T-shirts and mugs specifically just for this event, a limited quantity of each. And in conjunction with that, we will talk to you briefly about, they have a show coming up that they're promoting in the middle of May that is called
Battle of the Brits. It is
the Beatles against the Rolling Stones.
Beatles and the Rolling Stones,
yeah.
That's correct.
A Beatles tribute band versus a Rolling Stones tribute band taking place here at Shea Center in May. All right, the next band we want to talk about.
So Chris Butler is a name that you might not be familiar with, but you're definitely familiar with his work. It's kind of funny. He was always writing songs. He actually studied something that had nothing to do with music, but ended up really finding a passion for songwriting and playing guitar. He wrote songs for a couple different bands and started this interesting little process of making up fake bands to write songs for in order to get himself out of his head and into the heads of potentially different artists to perform the songs. One of those fake bands was called The Waitresses, which ended up becoming very real, as we know, fronted by a female singer, Patty Donahue, and also with a female bassist, Tracy Wormworth, who unfortunately will not be there, but Chris Butler will, and he was the mastermind behind it all. Here's I Know What Boys Like.
One, two, three, four.
I know what boys like, I know what guys want. I know what boys like, I got a boys like. I know what boys like, I know what guys want. I see them looking. I make them want me. I like.
That's Chris right there.
They want to touch me. I never got them. I know what boys like, I know what guys want. I know what boys like, boys like, boys like me.
All right.
And if we can actually rewind it back to that count in, little known fact, that 1, 2, 3, 4 up front, that is our friend Chris Butler as well.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There he is.
That was Chris.
See it happen in real life next week.
Yeah, that's
true. Making history.
1, 2, 3, 4.
We might do that 50, 60 times next week just to upset the audience. But that is Chris Butler. Great, great guy. And he is also going to jump on stage with us when we do Walk This Way with DMC, and he's going to play guitar.
Very cool.
So it'll be an all-star jam. There we go. So before you ask us any questions, which you may have, we have one more question for you. Our final trivia question of the day.
Get ready.
Get mentally and physically prepared for this. Are you ready?
Do your jumping jacks. Go.
Name three of Taylor Dayne's biggest hits. We're not going to sing any. We're not going to give you any clues. We actually gave you the answer earlier. So hopefully you were taking all the notes.
66% of the answer. Yeah.
We
just
gave them
two.
Ready?
What's happening? Yeah.
We have I Will Always Love You, Tell It to My Heart, and Love Will Lead You Back.
Yeah! Oh, that's correct.
Way to go.
Who won that?
And that is Christina R.
Christina R.
Yeah, wow. Christina.
Christina, are you smart? Yes, you are. Christina, there we go. So we had Michael and Lazar. Did I say that right?
Lazara, I think. Yep.
Lazara. And Christina R. That's really
are
cool.
Are you excited to get your ticket?
That's right. Christina, are you coming Friday night? Yes, you are. There we go. So thank you guys for participating. Do you have any questions? If you have a question, type it in. Sharon will let us know and we will lie.
Yes. If you have any questions, type them in right now. Let's see. Oh, Pablo is saying it was too fast.
Really?
Yes. You know, answering well, questions was too fast.
Well, we have speed typers.
That's right.
They've
yes.
been training for this. They've been typing with weights on their fingers for weeks, just waiting for this moment.
Pablo, the best class I ever took in high school was typing. Sophomore year of high school. It saved me hours of my life.
I agree. There's no questions, but if anyone has any, please feel. Oh, Pablo said okay.
Thank you, Pablo, for your. Yes.
We hope to see you anyway.
Yes. It doesn't mean we don't like you.
And just so some information, we have somebody on this webinar who was the music director at WPSC in the 80s.
Who is it?
And he did not win. His name is Peter.
Oh, no kidding.
Yes, Peter.
Tell him I had a radio show on WPSC in the 1980s when I was my early days here at Wayne Patterson University, when it was just a college, merely a college.
And he said they had Billy Idol, Eddie Grant, and the Go-Go's were here when he was here.
That's right. I think the last big concert they had back in that era was Quiet Riot. And they used to have concerts at the Rec Center. And it's been Quiet Riot. I think there was not a riot, but there was some bad things that went on at that concert. And then they stopped having concerts. We used to have a Ticketmaster outlet. You used to be able to buy tickets here for shows. We're still a hub. We're still the best school ever. Ever.
Ever.
Harvard stinks. William Patterson's awesome, and you know it.
We all agree.
All right. So you may keep asking questions. Here's the information you need for tomorrow.
Well,
no,
I'll
next
get your
week.
Ticket. You know you want to.
Michael, Lazara, and Christina are all each going to get a pair of tickets, which will get your information. Sharon will collect your information, and we'll have that for you at the door at the box office next week on Friday, April 6th. For everyone else, please most definitely go to wp-presents.org now. Buy a ticket, buy a couple. If you're a student at William Patterson, it's free. If you are a senior citizen, it's only $20. It's $25. If you're not a senior citizen, not a student, if you're a student from another university or if you're in high school, it's $10. We have so many pricing options because we care about you, the people.
And remember, it is for a good cause. We're not just going to, you know, go out to dinner on all this. It is going toward music scholarships. And there are a lot of really hardworking people here who deserve it.
And people like Rachel and Sammy.
And just so everybody knows, we're going to send out an email to everyone right after this little presentation. So you can buy your tickets there, too. You'll be getting an email. And Peter says that back when he was here, REM was big and WPSC was cable access back then.
Yep. It was FM cable and I think it was an AM station. Yes.
I feel like Peter. You don't know Peter.
we were probably here. Peter, I was a freshman in 86 and I graduated in 90. When were you here?
Let's see what Peter says.
Yeah. Pablo, watch how quickly he can answer.
he was here from 82 till 84.
Oh, okay. I missed him. Okay.
Well, Peter, I hope you come to the concert next week and you can meet.
Hey, you guys can finally meet.
Yeah.
That's right, Peter.
I've been waiting like 30 years for this.
I've wanted to meet you for so long. The only way we can meet is next Friday night, April 6th at 7:05 with the opening band School of Rock House Band. And then Mark Goodman and Lori Majewski open the show at 7:30 p.m., by the way. It's not a morning show.
Yeah, no, we're not getting there that early.
That's right.
Not happening. Sorry, everybody.
Sharon, should we wrap this whole thing up then?
I think we should. And thank you, guys. It was really, really fun and really interesting. So I hope everyone who's on here enjoyed it. Oh, Pablo's going to be there, even though he didn't win a ticket.
Yes, Pablo!
Pablo, let us know who you are. I want to give you a high five at the door. You're just the coolest.
High fives for Pablo.
High fives for Pablo.
And so, Peter, too.
Yes. This is great, and we'll see everyone next Friday. And Pablo said thank you so much, and he will see you next Friday.
All right.
Good. Looking forward to it.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, Dave. Thank you, everyone. And we'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye-bye. Love you.